Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to cover the topics which are related to data types in Salesforce. So I'm going to explain four data types: text, text area, text area long, and text area rich. Before starting, let me share you how you can get me on YouTube. You can search my name. My channel will be available there. You can follow it to watch various Salesforce related videos. So now I'm going to search my custom objects that I created. So I'm going to create all those four data type related fields on employee object. So to create new custom field and relationship, we need to click on this new button. So at the bottom, you can see all four data types are available: text, text area, text area long, and text area rich. So first I'm going to create text data type related field. So you can read this description. It allows users to enter any combination of letters and numbers, right? So I'm creating text field. Name of the field will be designation. Now here I can mention the length. So I'm mentioning length as 30. Field API name will be designation. Here I can mention description and help text. So I'm filling the description. This field contains designation of employee. Help text, please fill employee designation. Now we have certain options like required, unique, or external ID. So as per the requirement, you can check these check boxes, and you can also put some default value. So this is the text data type, so you need to put the default value inside double quotes. Now I'm clicking on next. So here I am selecting visible for all the profiles. So this field will be visible and editable for all the profiles. Clicking on next. I want to show this field on employee layout, so that's why I'm leaving it as it is. And I'm clicking on save. Now I'm going to open this employee tab in new browsers tab. So here you will see, if I click on new designation field will be available. So here it is. So here you can fill the designation of employee, and this is help text, which is showing please fill employee designation. So if you want to show this help text, then you can fill it while creating the field. Otherwise you can leave that help text as blank. Then it will not be shown here, right? So this way I created one text related field. Now I am going to create another field. So next field is related to text area data type. So here is the description. It allows users to enter up to 255 characters on separate lines. So now the difference: in case of text data type, you can enter the data in single line only. If you want to enter the data in separate lines, then you can choose text area. But here the limit is you can enter up to 255 characters only. So I'm selecting text area as the data type for this field. Label will be family background. Field API is family background. Now I am leaving description and help text as blank. Now one option is there, required. So if you want to make this field as required for all the records, then you can select this checkbox as true. Otherwise leave it as it is. Then you can pick the default value that you want to show. Thank you. For this field also, I'm making it visible for all the profiles. Then I'm going to put this on the employee layout. So I'm leaving it as it is, as checked, clicking on save. So text area field is also created. You can see it here. Here it is, family background. Now I'm going to refresh this. So here you can see this field is available here, and this way you can fill details in separate lines, and scroll bar will be available there. So you can scroll it up and down so that you can read the information properly, right? So this way text area field works. Now I'm going to create text area long. So I'm choosing data type as text area long. So its description says it allows users to enter up to 131072 characters on separate lines. So it is an add-on for text area. So if you want more characters, then you can choose text area long. And if you are comfortable with 255 characters only, then you can choose text area. So here, label will be career objective. So it is showing this default value as length, and max is 131072. So you can choose this value, you can put your own value, or you can directly put this maximum limit. It depends on the requirement. And here you can see it is showing the overall limit for the org, or you can say for this object. You are currently using 0 out of 1638400 characters on this object. So you have additional characters to allocate to this field. So it is showing maximum number of character limit for this object. So you have to choose character limit appropriately so that we can utilize this limit for many fields under a single object. So don't put this max value as it is, because if you put this, then your other fields will suffer. They will not be having proper characters limit while creating those fields. Then we have a number of lines visible. So suppose I am making it 5. Then it is the field API, then description, help text, and then default value. Now I'm clicking on next. So it will also ask for field level security for profile. So I'm making it visible for all profile. Putting it on employee layout and clicking on save. So our third field is created, which is of type text area long. So here is the data type. It is showing the number of characters that we can type under this field. Now again, I'm going to refresh. So here you can see career objective is available and default number of lines are 5. So here also you can type in different lines. So this way you can fill the details in separate lines, right? So as per your requirement, you can fill the details and you can choose the appropriate data type for creating fields, right? So I hope you understood about text, text area, and text area long. Now last one is text area rich. So read this description. Allows users to enter formatted text, add images and links, and it allows up to 131072 characters on separate lines. So you can also format your text. You can add images and links if you select text area rich as data type. So I am selecting this. its label will be certification details. Then again, the limit for particular object, character limit, you can choose wisely the length of this field. So suppose I want to choose only 2000 characters, so length will be 2000. Visible lines are 25, you can increase or decrease this value. Then description and help text, if you want this, you can fill it. Now I'm clicking on next. It is also asking for field level security. I am making it visible for all the profiles. Then it is asking, do you want to put this field on page layout? Yeah, I want. So I'm making it visible for the layout. Now, refreshing this page. So here you can see, this is certification detail field and it is text age. So suppose if I type this certification details and I want to make it bold, italic, underline. So this way you can apply the formatting. If you want to align some text like, Salesforce admin, and you want to make it in center of the this text area, so you can choose this alignment. So here you can apply required formattings also. If you want to write something in left, you can choose left alignment. Then these are bullets and numberings. Then this is for undo, this is for redo. From here you can pick a particular image, you can put link with the help of this button. So this way you can apply certain formatting on this field. So this is text area rich. So this way I demonstrated you four different fields, or you can say four different data types to create fields. So first was text, second was text area, third was text area long, and fourth is text area rich. So you can choose any one of them as per the requirement in your project or assignments. I hope you understood the demonstration, whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, you can follow me on YouTube. Thank you for watching this video.